practicing on, quite been practicing on Wednesday nights. I'll be in my office and get to hear them sing, and it's just, you're in for a treat this morning. It's going to be a wonderful time of worship, and so glad you're here today. Before I pray, let me share with you, I just wanted, this is Palm Sunday. Let me share with you a passage of scripture from John 12. The next day, the great crowd that had come for the great feast heard that Jesus was on his way to Jerusalem. They took palm branches and went out to meet him, shouting, "Hosanna! Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is the King of Israel." Jesus found a young donkey and sat upon it, as it is written, "Do not be afraid, O daughter of Zion. See, your king is coming, seated on a donkey's colt." At first, his disciples did not understand all this. Only after Jesus was glorified did they realize that these things had been written about him and that they had done these things to him. We're also blessed the children's choir is going to lead us off here in a moment, and always a blessing. So what a great day the Lord has planned for us. Let's pray together. Father, we thank you and praise you for this day. Thank you for your presence that's in this place. I thank you for the opportunity and the privilege we have to worship you. I thank you for the children's choir and the choir, and may you just use them to share your message with us this morning. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
I with the armor truck with that. He lives 533. Let's all stand together.
Thank you. presence of holiness, mercy, and love. It was what my brother Andrew and I felt when we encountered Jesus for the first time. We knew right away that there never had been, and there never will be, anyone else like him.
Messiah would one day appear, and we list of people that the Messiah would want to sit down and talk to, I doubt that my name would ever have appeared. I was an outcast among outcasts. The Jews looked down on the Samaritans, and the Samaritans looked down on me, a woman who flaunted society's idea of how a good woman should act. You probably have heard my story many times, the story of how I met Jesus at the well and how he asked me to give him a drink of water. He told me that he could give me a different kind of water so I would never thirst again. He knew all about me and the life I had lived. Talking to Jesus that day, I felt something I had never felt before. Although he knew me, he didn't condemn me. He didn't approve of my choices, but he talked with me as if I mattered. There was something about being with him that made me feel as though his presence could make a real difference in my life.
In and out of situations that tug of war at me, all day long I struggle for answers that I
There is such power in God's presence. He is almighty, and yet his might is perfectly balanced by his overwhelming love. He loved the world so much that from the very beginning he made a plan for our redemption, and he created every place and everything that would make it happen. At noon on the day of his crucifixion, the darkness was so great that it was like midnight. 3 hours later, Jesus declared from the cross, "It is finished," and then he died. Though I had not followed him publicly, I went to Pilate and asked for permission to bury his body. Nicodemus and I wrapped it in cloth and laid it in a tomb that had never been used. How hopeless and final it all seemed. Early on Sunday morning, the women who had followed Jesus during his ministry went to the tomb before dawn to anoint his body. But their spices went unused and forgotten, because instead of finding his broken body, they discovered an empty tomb and an angel who told them, "Jesus isn't here, he's alive. Go and tell Peter and the rest of his disciples." This is the news we never got tired of proclaiming. Death has been conquered by the cross. The grave has been swallowed up by his victory. Jesus is alive.
Why then are the peace?
That's why we're able to live and have life, eternal life, and eternal life that's even now. What a great message we've heard this morning. And our hymn of invitation this morning is 324, Have You Been to Calvary? As we stand and as we sing, if you need to respond this morning, won't you come to the invitation? Encourage you to be here for deacons. We'll have our April deacons meeting tonight, since April, next Sunday, the first Sunday, is Easter. And so we should remember, ask our deacons to remember that. You see other announcements, bulletin, are there others that, other announcements that need to be made? Okay. Let me share some prayer requests for you. Barry Collins, most of you know him, he's been having some heart issues. In fact, had a heart attack this week, and they did some stents and angioplasty and stuff like that. So remember Barry in your prayers. Ron Blanton has knee surgery coming up in a couple of weeks, so let's be praying for him. Remember Miss Faye Kitchens, Randy's mom, as you know her. He said this morning she has good days and bad days, so let's pray for more good days and less bad days. Margaret Martin got some tremendous news this week, and yes, you want to share? You're going to get shit.
There's only about an inch of the wound, which covered the whole top of her foot, that is not healing, but it's looking good. And so she has no big bandage on, no crutches. She says, I feel free.
So just pray. It's wonderful when we see prayers after like that. Just pray that after it heals up and she'll be done with this thing. And since this story is inspired by any spider you see, you stomp it. If you have a shoe on first. And also shake your shoes and everything else, right? Also, we ask that you pray for our daughter-in-law, Jessie. This coming Friday is her due date. And she said that baby come anytime she's ready. And so we're waiting on a phone call just any day now. So pray for her and healthy delivery, healthy baby, all that good stuff. We appreciate that. Any others we need to pray for this morning?
Brother Bradson is back in the hospital. He had some trouble with it. He had fluid built up around so bad that it collapsed one of his lungs. They had called the ambulance. He did COVID on the way to the hospital. He's in ICU.
Butch is pastor of Union Baptist, and many of you know him, and he's a good friend, so I appreciate you sharing that. Unspoken request, are there other unspoken requests? Any others that we need to lift up in prayer? We pray there's one singing again. Okay. Let's sing, go back to singing home. If you want to. Or you want to sit down?
Yeah, you can sit
down. Okay, all right. Let's pray together. Father, we thank you and praise you for this day. Thank you for all your blessings and just